Hello, everybody. My name is Monica Tutaj. I'm research scientist in Rat Genome Database, Medical College of Wisconsin. And in this poster presentation, I'm going to talk about genome variants analysis of 72 rat strains that belong to hybrid rat diversity panel. So what is hybrid rat diversity panel? It's a cohort of classic inbred rat strains and recombinant inbred strains. Almost 100 of rat strains were carefully selected based on usage and research of disease-associated traits, often complex traits that cannot be explained by the genetic segregation of a single gene, and most likely derived from multiple genes and exhibit variety of phenotypes. Diseases like heart, lung, blood disorders, changes of behavior under certain conditions, and other I list is here under each group. This combination of classic and recombinant inbred rat population will allow researchers to define the genomic regions associated with a phenotype of interest or quantitative trait loci, QTLs, and hopefully with greater mapping resolution compared with traditional linkage studies. So the objective of this project is creating a diverse, stable, and reproducible rat reference population, so the scientists would be able to discover and characterize molecular mechanisms underlying complex disease-related traits. Part of this effort is identifying and collecting genetic variation for all HRDP strains. I will show you the results from the analysis of whole genome sequencing of Illumina short reads of 72 rat strains. We follow the genome analysis toolkit best practices recommendation of Broad Institute team. Data pre-processing steps involve marking adapter sequences, alignment to the NURAT genome reference, MRAT Brown Norway 7, and also marking duplicates. Mapping reads to genome reference. So it allows us to evaluate the coverage and performance of the whole genome sequencing. Mean base coverage value ranges from roughly 15 to 68x, and the estimated sensitivity to detect heterozygous sites as a function of coverage and base quality distribution ranges drops quickly when mean coverage is below 20x, which is the red bar on a graph. And that is estimation, and we will see real data from the covariant. In the joint variant call process, we identified four types of variants. Roughly two-thirds of variants were single nucleotide variants and one-third indels. When we compared analysis with old rat genome assembly from 2041 and 06, we see big drop 8 to 9% of indels discovered with new genome reference. On this variant density plot, you can see orange spots, and that are genome location with high number of variants accumulation, particularly chromosome Y, but in brown Norway rat is difficult to properly assemble, so we don't have yet high quality reference chromosome Y for rat. And we can see here number and fractions of single nucleotide variants and indels per sample. So total number of single nucleotide variants per sample was up to 6 million and around 2 million of indels, except brown Norway, strains, classic and recombinant, that have around 5-6 times lower number of variants. So you can see the two recombinant panels below, and on the top is the classic inbred strains group. In the process of assessment of variant quality, we applied hard filtering method. So each variant must pass 6 parameter threshold. So after applying those filters, we can see the numbers of total variants dropped, and only variants supported by more than 10 reads were selected as a high confidence variant set. To compare our results with previous studies, we can see nice increase in variants number, defining bigger population of rats. So we've got higher number and more complete data sets Next, we analyze prediction of variance consequences on the transcript level using two gene model annotation from NCBIN and ensemble, as they are different. So here I'm showing SNP effect prediction summary and also damaging score prediction from PolyFen2 for protein level in number of genes grouped by RGD Olga tool for gene list generation. And you can see that it's divided by the ontologies for disease groups. And I summarize it in this table below. Choosing the ontology and terms, you can explore genes that are annotated for multiple diseases in this Olga tool. And after creating the final set of genes, you can further analyze them using RGD toolbox set. For example, if you submit it to variant visualizer, you can see the variance distribution, the set of genes. You can check for human clean var score and also select rat strains of interest, set filters for the damaging variants, and the tool will return you SNPs that which match the input criteria, including information on read depth, zygosity, conservation score, and more here on this transcript panel. So here I'm showing you that there are more available species in variant visualizers to explore for your gene lists. For genomic variants, you can see that for rats, we separated the HRDP cohort. Variants are also available in the VCF format file on a RGD download site. So you can easily download those sets and analyze it yourself. In summary, I presented you today the results of analysis of the whole genome sequencing data from 72 rat strains that belong to hybrid data diversity panel. And if you'd like to hear more about our research tools, please contact me. Thank you.